Well, if you have a fussy eater at home, dinner time can be a battle and a messy one at that. There are children who freak out at the very sight of Brussels sprouts on their plate. So how can parents win this fight? Well, they can start by taking a page from a mom who's been there.
Jennifer Tyler Lee struggled to get her kids to eat healthy foods, so she came up with a game called Crunch-A-Color that made eating vegetables fun.
Like every other parent, I want my kids and family to be happy and healthy. And for me, that means eating healthy together as a family.
Her book, The 52 New Foods Challenge, is a step-by-step guide to help change the way your children eat, one new food at a time.
Well, Jennifer Tyler Lee is here with us now, and we welcome you to the 700 Club.
Thank you so much for having me.
There was a point with your own children where you tried to force them to eat what you thought
That's
was good
right.
for them. How'd that work for you?
This story starts at my family table. We had a big struggle, but parents across the nation struggle with this problem, mm-hmm. and it's part of a much bigger issue, which is really the health and strength of our families. We need to bring our families back to the table to enjoy wholesome foods and cook wholesome foods together. It's about setting our kids up for a lifetime of healthy habits and strengthening our families.
So you did this successfully by going from arguing with your kids and even forcing them to eat food that was healthy for
That's
them to
it.
Making a game out of it. Where did that come from?
It all starts from making it a game and making it fun. And actually the inspiration was my husband. He turns everything into a game. And so I watched him one morning getting the kids ready for school. And I thought, why don't I take that same idea and apply it at the table?
That's wonderful. You've written a book about it. You've got an actual game. We've got it over here. We're going to show you
Thank
in a little
you.
Bit. But
yes.
Because you too can have this game. But the book is called The 52 New Food Challenge.
Yes, The 52 New Foods Challenge.
So what is that? What's
it
the challenge?
It is a very simple step-by-step guide to change the way that your family eats one new food at a time. It's designed to get you and your family involved in a transformative process to change what you eat. And all it takes is 30 minutes each week.
And it's a weekly, that's why the 52
is.
Comes from.
Yes.
So each week you're going to introduce something new.
Each week you try something new, you set aside 30 minutes once a week and cook together as a family.
Now cooking together is part of the process and the fun for all of this, right? That the child actually is involved in some of the food prep.
It is.
You know, there are a lot of busy people today, Jennifer.
That
is this time consuming?
And I am a busy mom too, and I completely understand that. But making healthy food taste delicious and preparing it in a way that your whole family is gonna love can be very easy if you have a good plan. So that's exactly the solution I try and provide in the
book.
Well,
you've got a good plan for us here today.
Thank
We're
you.
Gonna
I
look at three different things that you've brought, but let's start down here and talk about
I like that. Okay, so apples. Apples are a great place to start because new doesn't have to mean a new scary food. It can be a familiar food prepared in a
Maybe
new
that's
way.
Even the best place to start.
Absolutely, mm-hmm. right? So start with a familiar food. It's a fun way to start cooking together. All right, so what we're gonna show are baked apple chips. This is also a great way to get off packaged foods. This is something you might buy at the market, easy to make at home. So there's a quick tip, which is all you do is you slice off the base of the apple so that when you turn it over, it uh-huh. doesn't roll away on you.
Okay.
Now, this might be for someone who's a more advanced chef in your house, maybe not the four-year-old. Slice through it. And then what you're going to do, look at that beautiful pattern inside, mm-hmm. but you're going to slice them thin, just like that, and then toss them with, you can put them on the pan, and then add a little bit of cinnamon if you like. You can
okay.
do a little bit of cinnamon or a little bit of nutmeg, and we bake those in a low temperature oven for about 90 minutes.
So basically you're dehydrating them,
That's
really,
it. And
right?
flip them partway through, and they're so delicious. They're great as a Let's snack.
Oh.
What do you think?
Ooh, they are good.
So yummy. And that's apples. That's
yeah.
just apples, right?
Very fresh tasting.
Delicious.
Okay.
And so special when you make them at home.
I love Brussels sprouts, but most people don't like them because it's a strong taste.
Well, I have to tell you a secret. I didn't like Brussels sprouts when we first started either.
Really?
So Brussels sprouts can be really challenging, but here's what I think they're a great illustration of this this recipe in particular, is experimenting with tastes and textures. So my daughter didn't so much like the mushy centers of Brussels sprouts, many people don't, but she did like the crispy chips. So we decided, let's make a whole recipe with just the crispy chips.
So you just took, you take, they're so easy to peel.
Well, and there's a really easy trick. So this sprout has a little end, mm-hmm. just chop off the end, just like that. Uh-huh. And then the leaves peel away easily.
They come off naturally.
Mm-hmm. This is a fantastic job for your kids. It will keep them busy for about 20 minutes. Perfect.
You still have the rest of the day to figure out what you're going to
do. Exactly.
So this is what you've done here. These are all just the leaves
peeled off. You just get the leaves and then I toss them straight onto the pan, right? I don't even put them in a bowl. I add a little olive oil and a little bit, you can add the olive oil if you want, a little bit of kosher salt. That's good. Just dress it around like that.
Okay.
I toss them straight on the pan, add a little bit, that's a little maybe too much salt, but that's okay. Toss them straight on the pan and then roast them. Start
Same
at 350. Then turn it for 10 minutes, turn it down a little bit.
Wow, they melt in your mouth.
And they're like a healthy swap for potato chips.
Ooh, good breakfast, Pat.
So yummy.
Let's move down here.
So yummy and easy.
This looks wonderful too.
Okay, so mini frittatas. Here's why I love this, because everybody gets to do it their own way.
Awesome.
So it's a great way to do a DIY dinner or breakfast for dinner.
So you do it like this, you just put out all the fixings and...
That's it. And you let everybody choose what they want to add. What I encourage with my kids is make two for yourself and two to share, and then we trade. And everybody tries a little bit of something new, because what you might add might be different than what another person might add.
So you're doing this in just little rubberized...
These are fantastic because they can go in the lunchbox the next day too.
Hmm.
So easy. So you just add a little bit of the egg, so you can go ahead and pour that in if you want, and then choose whatever kinds of ingredients you want to add. You might put a little bit of kale in and tomato if you want to do a veggie version, whatever you like, or maybe it's mushrooms and bacon.
And here's the finished product.
Super easy.
I mean, these are beautiful.
And great for breakfast for dinner or lunch.
Wow. Wow,
lots of different ways to serve
that. These are just a couple of the ideas that you're going to find in this book. If you're tired of food fights, you need to get Jennifer's book. It's called The 52 New Foods Challenge, and it's filled with great ideas. Plus, turn dinner time into a game with Crunch a Color. They're both available in stores nationwide. What a creative, great way to
Thank
get kids
you
eating
so
healthy.
Much. I hope it'll be fun to cook together as a family.
Grandparents and parents, so do it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have fun.
Have you with us.
Enjoy.